Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lahu wa ashhadu anna muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluhu amma ba'du fa'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim bismillahir rahmanir rahim Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim Malik Yawm Al-Din Iyyaka na'budu wa iyyaka nasta'in Ihdinas siratal mustaqim Siratal ladhina an'amta 'alayhim ghayril maghdubi 'alayhim وللضالين والله أنزل من السماء ماء والله أنزل من السماء ماء فأحيا به الأرض بعد موتها Inna fi dhalika la ayatun li qawmin yasma'un Was-samai dhati raji wal-ardi dhati sadu
Ye ayat jo maine padhi hain
Bismillahirrahmanirrahim Huzur says that this is the first verse of Surah Nahl. The translation of this is that Allah Almighty caused the water to descend so that he revived with that the earth which had gone dead. And there is certainly a sign in those for those people who listen. And the other is from Surah Tariq 12 and 13. And in the name of that sky which is full of water and that earth which brings forth the growth. There is no doubt, Huzur says, that any person who believes in Allah Almighty and believes in Allah, he definitely recognizes this fact that it is Allah Almighty who is running the whole system of this universe. Whether they have the full perception of this or not, but in everybody's mind, this concept that Allah Almighty is almighty and powerful, this conception is definitely there, and at least in the mind of everyone who is a Muslim, and according to his mental ability and capabilities, this concept is there. An ordinary Muslim also understands this, that and everything which is found in that has been created by Allah. Rather, everything which is in heaven and earth, everything has been created by Allah. And it is with the permission of Allah Almighty that everything is created. And it is sustained with the help of Allah. And it is with the permission of Allah Almighty, everything is going to perish. And it happened in the past, and it will happen continue to happen in future. Zur says that this point is also understood by all people according to their capabilities, and they understand it according to their capacity. That the one who has created the effectiveness in the creation of Allah, that is only Allah Almighty. He is the one who is the Lord of the universe. Not only the human beings, but all the creations according to their specified time of remaining here, He is looking after the nourishment of that. And particularly the human beings who are the best of the creation, for Him, He has created a lot of His creation, and they have been appointed to serve the human beings. And in order to improve this worldly life, in order to improve that, and without any human effort, Allah Almighty has arranged for so many means. And then, in order to demonstrate this quality of rububiyat, the nourishment, He not only shows the manifestation of His rahimiyat, being graceful and merciful, He does not create the means without asking, but also shows the manifestation of the one who gives without any action, and also shows the manifestation of responding the one who listens to the prayer. And in order to keep the life going on, He shows the manifestation of so many of His attributes. If, for example, there is a drought, and then listening to the wailing and crying of the people, then He makes the rain the means of providing the means of the sustenance of mankind, accepting the prayer. He shows the manifestation of His mercy and kindness. So when we see that in this worldly life, Allah Almighty looks after this His creation in this temporary worldly life, in so many ways He has set up the whole system for that. So then when Allah Almighty says that I have fixed another life for human beings, so for that also I have set up a system. The foundation of that is in this very life. And it is based on every action that we do in this worldly life, that action which is promoting the spirituality and in human beings. And this spirituality will enable that person for the rewards in the hereafter, which Allah Almighty has fixed for that life to come. All those deeds and actions which are done for the attainment of the pleasure of Allah Almighty, Allah Almighty in that life will reward all those actions. This thing, a mu'min, a believer, a Muslim, they definitely know about all these things. And they also know that in this and the true Muslims, they also know that Allah Almighty has set up a spiritual system for this purpose. And those who do not have the full perception and understanding, they also need to think over it, that when Allah Almighty, for the system of this universe, Allah Almighty has arranged so many things, which is the whole thing is a temporary thing. So then the life hereafter, which is permanent, there must be some arrangements for that. And Allah Almighty in this very life, and a person becomes able to benefit from this system in this very life. So certainly a spiritual system is there in this life, which Allah Almighty has established. And according to that, Allah Almighty sends His messengers and prophets. Those in their respective times, they come like that rain, and they came just like the rain, which for the believers of those people, they were like that water and rain which irrigated the land. and they become the means of their spiritual and religious progress. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam says that you also remember this point, that the points which inform us about the existence of Allah Almighty, and these are the prophets who let us know about the existence of Allah Almighty. If these pious people had not come in this world, then to find the straight path, the Sirat-e-Mustaqim, would have been almost impossible. Although by looking at the creation of the heaven and the earth and their very sublime setup, a right-minded person, a person with sound thinking, can find out that the whole structure and the whole universe, there must be a maker of all that. But in this sentence, that there is in this statement that there should be, and in this sentence that there is a difference. And certainly, those people, persons who definitely inform about the existence of Allah, they are the prophets, those who have proved with thousands of miracles that being which is utmost hidden and out of sight, that is really in existence. And the fact of the matter is, the truth of the matter is that the fact is that this height of intellect, that is also something which has benefited from the fountain of prophethood. And because of the prophethood, this intellect is created. If the presence of the prophets had not been there, so then this much intellect would not have been achieved by the people. And the example of that although under the earth the water is there, but the sustenance and the presence and the availability of this water is depending on the rain. When the rain does not come from the sky, then the water underneath the earth, that also finishes. And when the water comes from the sky, then the water under the earth, that sprouts out and gushes out. And similarly, with the advent of the prophets, the intellect is quickened. And that intellect improves in its quality. And when the time passes by on this, that a prophet is not there, so then the worldly water of this intellect becomes muddy and not so good. And there are so many vices, like setting up partners with Allah Almighty and so many others, they are created. So similarly, as we see that there is a light in the eye, but despite that light, still that eye is depending on the light from from the sun. Similarly, these things which are similar to eyes, they are always depending on the light of the prophethood. When that sun is out of sight, then immediately those eyes, they become blurred. So can you see everything with eyes? No, not at all. Similarly, without the light of the prophethood, you cannot see anything. So this is the law of nature, law of Allah Almighty, that for the improvement of the practical and intellectual progress of the people, unless the water does not descend from the heaven, which is fresh and pure, which spiritually speaking polishes the human souls, and that action which is which should become the means of the spiritual and mental development, and through which these fruit trees should develop, and they should become the means of satiating the hunger and the thirst of the people. And as we see that if this physical rain does not come for some time and there is a period of drought, then the people, because of the shortage of grain, they die. And those people who depend on agriculture, their crops are dry. So then they become restless and extremely worried. And sometime with great agony and pain, people write to me, and the prayer for the seeking of the prayer is offered, namaz-e-istisqa. And those people who might have been offering the prayer occasionally, but when this condition comes, the condition of drought, then with great pain and with their souls melting, they pray for that. And they pray for the rain so that they can have their both hands to meet, they can enable to make their both hands meet and have some food to eat, so that they can have some food, and with the improved provisions they can benefit from the blessings of Allah. The rain is such a thing, Hazur says, that on which every person is depending on that, whether they are poor countries, whether they are rich countries, whether people are poor, whether the people are rich, in order to fill their belly, they are depending on, they are in need of having some food. And this food depends on the water. Whether it is from the rivers or from the wells, the water in the wells, that comes up because of the water of the rain. And then it becomes useful. It becomes good for use. And when the rains are not there, then the water disappears in the well. So Allah Almighty has made this worldly water out of His bounty. Allah Almighty has described this water as a great bounty, that if the water in the fountains gets dry, then what are you going to do? And what will be your condition in that case? So as I said, that in this worldly life, a human being, very desperately, in agony, he begs for water from Allah Almighty. But that, for that life, which is permanent life, for that, he does not get so much worried about that, does not care that much. And nor when the water comes, then he does not really benefit from that and becoming grateful. And for that, actually, the effort should have been much more. No doubt there are some people, those who become extremely restless and worried, and they pray to offer very fervent prayers to Allah Almighty for the water, which can bring back to their life, spiritually speaking, and provide all the worldly means, worldly life as well. But the majority of the people, they do not pay any attention to that. They are completely unaware of that, and this is a out of the blessings of Allah Almighty, this is one of the blessings, that because of His Rahmaniyat and Rabubiyat, He makes this arrangement through which Allah Almighty makes the arrangement of the permanent life of the on the earth. These verses which I have recited in the beginning, as you have listened to in the translation, Allah Almighty has mentioned the subject of the coming of the rain, which is the physical water and also the spiritual water. The spiritual water is mentioned more in the first verse from Surah Nahl. The first verse of Surah Nahl, as I said, particularly Allah Almighty has mentioned, وَاللَّهُ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً. And Allah Almighty has caused this water to descend from heaven. And then He said, فَاهِيَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا. And from this water, after the earth had become dead, He has given it life. And then Allah Almighty says, إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَسْمَعُونَ. That certainly in that, for those people, there is a great sign for those people who listen. That is to say, that message which has been revealed from God Almighty, they listen to that, they heed. Yasmaun, the word has been used. So the water is seen, water is, people drink it. So it means, by the word yasmaun, it is clearly indicated that people, they listen to that message, the spiritual message that comes, and they try to reform their life and to make it better. So the example of this has been the message from Allah Almighty, the example of that has been given with water. that if they listen to that and act upon that one, then certainly this is something which is going to give them the spiritual life. So while in this message, and the greatest message which came, and the perfect message that was revealed, that is the Holy Quran. So in this verse, there is a message that the Holy Quran is that message which is going to grant you the life. In this, the status of the Holy Quran and the greatness of the Quran has been mentioned. And this principle has also been mentioned here, that through the prophets, that spiritual water descends, which gives a new life to the dead hearts. Before the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, all those prophets who came, they also in their circles, in their areas, they gave new life to the dead people in those areas. But along with that, they also made the prophecy of the Prophet to come in future. That Prophet who will bring such a pure and fresh water, and he would bring that water so much nourishing and giving the new life to the people. And the area of that will be, you know, expanding to the whole world. So the Holy Quran is that perfect and complete, which is for all times, and such a water, and it is such a water that at that time when the earth was at the highest point of its the state of death, then to the dead hearts it gave the message of life. And the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, on whom this message was revealed, and whose spiritual water actually gave new life to the dead people. And Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, describing that period and the mention of the giving their life to the dead, he mentions that the history tells us clearly, and the Holy Quran, many passages, many places, it has been mentioned very clear, it has been noted there, that the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came at a time when in the whole world there was shirk, the association of partner with Allah Almighty, and the worship of human beings had spread, and people have left the true faith, the true path, and they had forgotten the straight path, and all these groups, they had invented their own innovations. In the Arabs, the idol worship was very common, and in Hind as well, in India, and there were a lot of other human worship was very common in those days, and many people at that time, and there were so many books in the Hindu, and because of that, many human beings were made God. Such a books had been printed, and all according to Padre Paul, and many scholarly English people, and the Christianity was the most corrupt religion at that time, and because of the bad behavior of the Christian people at that, there was a black spot on them. And not only one or two, but so many things were there, and they had been given the status of God. This what has Simaud alayhi salatu wasalam has mentioned in the party in Devonport, and other the English scholars, the reference which he has made, I don't give the other references here. Devonport, whatever he has written, the translation of that is regarding the condition at that time, that in one way there was a mispractice in the moral corruption was there in the Christians and the Jews people, and they had come to in the Arabian peninsula, they had come and settled there, and they had established strong communities there. And the condition of that, the Christianity at that time, and you cannot expect, you cannot imagine anything better than that. And the wise Christianity, Christian people, they were, dissatisfied with Christianity, and the practices of the Christian missionaries, that has left their churches unintended. And the various branches spread all over the Africa, and they had such very bad innovations had spread in them. They used to fight among them, and because of the fights, they were cut, and they were divided into sects and schism. And because of their brutality and wickedness and all these things, and the ignorance was there, it was the cause of so many problems. And the international entertainment and sexuality was present among the people. And these things were there, all these things were spread everywhere. And they were wasting their time. And they always thought of very horrible thoughts. And just once in a while, sometime, those people who were very fully armed, some groups used to go to the cities. They used to preach the same thing in the churches, and they used to force these people to believe these things. And in Christianity, instead of that simple way of worship which was given by Jesus Christ, this practice has taken over from there. And then he says that the sacred things and the colored photographs, they had become the object of their worship, which for those people who were given the worship, the teaching of worship of one God, this was which he discovered from Iskandaria and in Damascus. These things were shown, and then he says, the Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, at the time of his advent, they said that all these people had left the practicing of their faith, and they had started a war, an unending war. And the Arab, and the people in Arab, they could see that the fundamental thing which was mentioned in their scripture, that was, they had gone far away. And the true worship of Allah Almighty, that was simply an illusion to them. And no doubt, those Christians, they were not much better than their the other people who used to worship their illusionary gods. And this is an apology to Muhammad. In that book he has mentioned, there is another one. In 1882, the book was published, Apology to God. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has given the reference of this book, and he says that at that time, the advent of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, at this time of misguidance of people, when the condition was actually requiring a reformer, and there was absolute need of divine guidance. And then by his advent, he to illuminate the whole world with his morals and good behavior, and to completely destroy all these innovations which had crept there. And that shows, that establishes that the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was the true prophet of Allah Almighty. And then he says that his being truthful is established from this point, that in this period of misguidance, the human life, divine law was in need of a reformer, because the old law of Allah, the Lord of universe, is there that when there the corruption goes to the highest point and misguidance goes to the highest point, then Allah Almighty, the mercy of Allah Almighty, takes care of improving the situation. That when there is a drought and the people are on the brink of death, then Allah Almighty brings the rain. And when, because of epidemic, thousands of people are about to die, and there is nothing, and then there is something of improvement, and some medicine is invented. And when somebody is captured in the hand of a tyrant, then somebody, a very just king, is created. Similarly, when people forget the right path and they forget the oneness of Allah Almighty, and then Allah Almighty, from him, he gives the full wisdom to someone, and he blesses that person with his revelation, then he that is sent for the guidance of a human race, so that all this corruption can be reformed. And the fact of the matter is that the provider, Allah Almighty, who is the source of sustenance of the whole universe, and who is the ultimate cause of the sustenance of the whole universe, then he does not take this quality of giving benefit to the mankind, does not take away and does not leave it alone. But any all the attributes of Allah Almighty, all these attributes, they come into play. And when according to the human thinking, when it becomes imperative that in order, this has been established clearly, that whenever there is some disorder, in order to smash that, when these things come to surface, and the histories make it very clear, and also particularly with the statement of the Holy Quran, this is established, that at the time of the advent of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, this trial and difficult situation was dominant, and the people had forgotten the right path going towards Allah Almighty, and everybody knows it fully well, that in this disorder which was present there, the one who reformed this situation and the one who took all the human beings from this state of darkness, the one who did it, that is only nothing but the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. So all these points, they clearly establish that the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is the true guide from Allah Almighty. Towards this argument, Allah Almighty has referred in the Khud Allah Almighty has mentioned in that one, that Tallahi laqad arsalna ila umamin min qablika fazayyana lahum ash-shaytanu amalahum fahuwa waliyuhum al-yawma wa lahum azabun alim wa ma anzalna alayka al-kitaba illa litubayyana lahum allazi ikhtalafu fihi wa hudan wa rahmatan liqaumi yu'minun وَاللَّهُ أَنزَلَ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَاءً فَأَحْيَا بِهِ الْأَرْضَ بَعْدَ مَوْتِهَا إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَآيَاتٍ لِقَوْمٍ يَسْمَعُونَ. That he says that we swear in the name of Allah, who is the fountainhead of all the benefits, and he is the sum total of all the good attributes, that we sent to various prophets. So, but these people had got corrupt with the deception of Satan. So Satan is their companion, and this book has been revealed for this very purpose, that so that these people, the disputes among them could be settled, and the decision could be announced. And the fact of the matter is that the whole earth had got corrupted. Allah Almighty revealed the water from heaven, and from a revival took place, so that it should. This is the sign of the truth of this book. Only for those people who listen, that is to say those who are the seekers after truth. So it says that all these three things which has been mentioned earlier on, through which we have deducted the inference that the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is a true prophet, and how clearly it has been established that those people who had gone corrupt and gone misguided for 100 years, and then the pure water, the sweet water, which comes as a guidance, which comes when the rains have stopped, and that always comes at a time when the rains have stopped. So this water comes down from heaven. So then this water saves the earth and the people from destruction. So this indicates that this is not related to the physical water, but the same thing applies to the spiritual water, which comes at that time. When the corruption is widespread, then the spiritual water comes. And at this time as well, in order to smash this misguidance, Allah Almighty reveals the spiritual water. And also Allah Almighty has given this second argument, that before the advent of the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, the whole people had got misguided. And also it is made very clear that in order to give new life to these spiritually dead people, Allah Almighty gave them the life. And Allah Almighty has put this argument of the truth of this book. And those people who are seekers after truth, and they have been guided to this point, that the Holy Quran is the book of Allah. So there, where Allah Almighty has mentioned that the accounts of the life of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned, and the truth of the Holy Quran has been mentioned there. At that time, the promised Messiah sallallahu alaihi has also mentioned the status of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The beauty of that also becomes very clearly evident, and in that is the reply to those so-called mullahs and those who consider themselves responsible of the religion, those who criticize Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, that God forbid that he has decreased the status of the holy status of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, and he has actually snatched the prophethood from him. So these people following these so-called mullahs, so instead of criticizing this greatest lover of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasalam, instead of doing that, instead of increasing in their injustice, and instead of crossing all the limits of injustice, they should think and ponder over it and pray. Otherwise, when they are going to stand before Allah Almighty, this will not avail, that somebody excited us or incited us. Everybody will be liable for his own account. So it is a point of thinking for the people, those who are opposing, taking part very actively in the opposition of Jama'at. So this, if they do not rely what we say, then they should at least study the Holy Quran diligently. And in the name of Khatm-e Nubuwwat, many things are being said about the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, about the promised Messiah. Now the 7th September came, in the name of Khatm-e Nubuwwat, what they should have done, they should have mentioned about the love of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But there they used very foul language, abusive language against the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. They simply abused the community, and they have incited the people that you kill these people because they are liable to killing. Are these things which they are doing in this age, are they do not indicate to those transition which has been mentioned by Davenport, about which the promised Messiah has said that the time of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, all these things were present there. Are these things do not indicate to the corruption of the state of this period, and are these not pointing out that the time of the divine rain for the guidance should be coming, and these people and the people before the before this time, they benefited from this guidance when it came, and they achieved very high spiritual status and establishing their relationship with Allah Almighty. They became the people of God. Their link with Allah Almighty was weakened. Certainly, they became very moral people, full of morals, and a people of God. And they became such people who had God with them. So therefore, for the general people, this is a point of thinking today at this time. It is a point worth thinking, and they are doing those things by following blindly these so-called mullahs. And have they thought on the condition of their mullahs and their moral behavior, their moral attitude? Have they seen that? Are these people worthy enough that they can turn these their followers, their people, full of morals? Do they have the right that they can make these people full of morals, or to make them those people who can show the way of Allah Almighty? These people, in their selfish egos, they are the prisoners of that. And how can these people bring the people, how can these mullahs bring these people to God? They are like the still water of the ponds, in which there is nothing but filth. And because of not getting any new water, fresh water, there is stinking there, instead of being a life-giving message. This is the source of all the diseases. And majority of these people, majority of them, they come into this, and they are of this category of people, regarding which the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has mentioned in one of his hadiths, that Hazrat Ali Raziyallahu ta'ala anhu has narrated this one. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said that very soon that such a time is going to come that there will be nothing but of Islam except the name, and nothing of the Quran will remain except the words, and the mosque at that time would be full of people, but they would be devoid of guidance, and their ulama, so-called ulama, they would be the worst creature under the firmament of heaven. And the disorders and the conspiracies will go out of that and come back. So they would become this fountainhead of all this corruption. And this is exactly the condition that we see today. When the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam claimed, when he was appointed by Allah, at that time these so-called ulama, they were in the same condition, and today as well their condition is the same. Now this description which Davenport has given about the Christians at that time, exactly the same situation is to be seen among the ulama today. Very few, very rarely may be there who tell the truth, or they listen to the truth and they want to say that. Basically, all of them, they have their own objectives in their minds, and in order to gain those objectives, they are crossing all limits. This description which Davenport has mentioned about the time of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that was exactly at the time of the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, and that is exactly the same today. The Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasalam, he made a prophecy regarding the time to come, and the translation of the hadith I have just mentioned to you, that is exactly this time. Word for word, everything is exactly like that. So this is not that we Ahmadis only say that, not for our any objective of our, and not for our own tabligh, or we are not alleging anything upon them. Rather, every person who loves justice, he says the same. During the time of the promised Messiah, they used to say the same, and some people, this is exactly what is being said by their own ulama, and I'm going to mention some of the examples, those who spoke the truth. Nawab Nurul Hasan Khan Sahib, in his book, Iqtirab al-Saat, it is mentioned there that the condition of the people is that those people who perform good deeds like prayer, fasting, hajj and zakat, and those the money that they spend on their members of their family, and their explanation is not, that is not according to the Sharia. Either they want to, by spending that money, they want to show off, or for any other purpose, they do it. And then he says that those days are gone, that people, for the sake of religion, they used to reject the world. Now everything which is done for the sake of religion, that is for the purpose of acquiring the worldly wealth. And then in this fire and in this fighting, how can it be called the jihad? And these are the things which are done by animal-like people. And if you are going to search for these things, maybe one in 1,000 you might come across such a people. These the fakir and the teachers and the dervish and the other people, those who are boasting their piety and nobility, they are actually rejecting the truth, and they are following the blindly, and they are animals, like they are animal-like human beings, and they are worshipping their own self, egos, selfish egos. And then they write that their friendship and enmity, their mutual fighting and disputes, this is simply for the sake of rancor, and not for Allah, not for Rasul and Messenger. And they are, but these people do not make any distinction between right and wrong, and lawful and unlawful, and they are always speaking out abuses to others, and deception, and you know, cheating other people and falsehood and innovations and all these things they consider as if these are the things left in their hand, and this is what they are doing day and night, and they are always busy in that, and this has become actually the means of their earning. And if they have got any fear of Allah Almighty, so then these people, and then these are those people who are following the Sunnah of the Holy Prophet, and but these have been considered as unsuccessful by other people. So all these conditions are not like that which was at that time when this water came. And the explanation of that, the Holy Prophet Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam has mentioned, and he did not explain for this purpose that there will be dryness and Islam will finish. Not for this purpose, rather he explained this point that they should search for the water in this age. Then Nawab Siddiq Hasan came, and very famous Ahle Hadith ulama, he was described by Mujaddid by some others, and Sivai Kaul Minan in that Belkail Mehen, in that book he writes that this in this age of corruption, and the truth has completely disappeared, and those scholars who consider themselves as scholars, the so-called scholars, their whole life is, instead of getting the knowledge, is simply to get the money, and day and night their activities are of ignorance, and the scholars have become like ordinary people, and ordinary people are just like animals, and the knowledge and the understanding is completely disappeared, and the bad things have been declared as good, and the conditions of the last day, the Qiyamah, is very clear for some time, and all these indications are very clear, and the pious people are going away, passing away one by one, and the rest will be just worthless, just like the skin of some certain trees. And then Abul Hasan Ali Nadvi, Qadianiyat, in his book he writes, he has written this book against us, but he has mentioned something of true. And he says that the world of Islam was in the grip of so many diseases, and the biggest block on the face was the idolatry and the association of partners with Allah Almighty, and the people were crying the names of other than Allah, and the absurd things was rampant everywhere, and this condition was definitely calling and requiring for such a reformer who should, among the society, he should remove these signs of the ignorance, and he should be chasing in all the houses and with great courage, and he should be spreading the message of unity of Allah and the message of La Ilaha Illallah Dinul Khalis. That slogan should be raised by him. But despite all that, as I said, it is their misfortune that they are the people who have denied the claim of the promised Messiah, alayhi salatu wasalam. Then describing the future, the situation of that period, Hasan Nadvi Sahib says that the condition of the Muslims at that time was just like that which is always seen at the time of the degradation of the nations. He says their lifestyle was so bad that the pen of the historian is feeling shy to describe that. And this fisk and disorder, that was become a part of their life, and they used to take pride in that. Drinking was common, and drugs, bhangs, this drugs was very common. And as a result of that, the morals and their mental faculties were being impaired and damaged. And the ladies were, in their religious meetings, these prostitutes used to come, and still they say that there is no need of water, or we are going to reform the world. And then Abul Ala Maududi Sahib writes that the majority of the people of all these people, that was completely in the grip of innovations and misguidance, which had been there among them before the guiding the right path, getting the guidance. And the condition was not better than the non-Muslims, and they were completely in the worshipping their own selfish egos, and the pure religious sentiments was to be found only in very, very rare people. And then he says, in 11th century Hijri, Islam was at the declining at its lowest ebb, and all the worries and problems were there, and all these problems which were there in them, they were coming to surface, and they had completely thought the idea of reformation and bad things, they overpowered them, and so many people who were dishonest, and those who, and there were such people, and the non-Muslims, they used to give them petty help, and they could serve their purpose. And in the name of Mullah, whenever it was made there, and there was no positive response from them. These are the conditions which they themselves are describing. So at this time, and in these conditions, was it not the time when the need of the divine water was so much important? When everybody was agreeing that this has been mentioned by the Holy Prophet ﷺ, and their words are very similar to the words of Hadith, and this verse type of creation which the Holy Prophet ﷺ has mentioned, are they not agreeing to this one? So when all these things were there, which were according to the prophecy of the Holy Prophet ﷺ, each and every word of that prophecy is being fulfilled, and these people, almost in those very words, they are admitting the fulfillment of that. I have given you some examples of that. But see that these so-called ulama and scholars, their books describe the condition of that even worse than that. But it is height of misfortune that when the true imam made the claim that they rejected that water which came from heaven, when he announced that I am the water which has come from heaven, and I am that light which has made the day bright, then they fixed the fatwa of kufr, disbelief upon him, and tried to turn away the people from him. And they forgot this hadith of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that when these conditions will be there, then the claim of the promised Messiah will be there, the Imam of the age will come, then it is my instruction to the Muslims that he would come in my following, in obedience to me. You convey my salam to him. Is this statement of the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam not 100% true, that Allah Almighty, those people of the latter days about whom he mentioned that they will be linked with the earlier people, in the time of whom the faith will go to Pleiades, and this community in the latter days, they will bring that faith back to the earth. Is this description which these ulamas are describing, is this not the thing of the same, that the faith has gone to Pleiades? So all just for their selfish gains, all these so-called ulama, one after the other, the generation after generation, these people are trying to deprive these people generation after. Oh, these people who are always looking for your good, for your benefit. Remember that the blessings of the Allah Almighty, if you want to get it, this is always done through those people who are sent by Allah Almighty, not through your own efforts. Hazrat Masih Maud alayhi salatu wasalam, after him, how many efforts have been made after his advent? These so-called ulama and scholars, against the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam, and the governments as well, they have joined. They have joined hand to finish this community. But have they been successful? But the community of the one who was sent by Allah Almighty, as I mentioned, I could not mention even the 1/5 of that portion which I had. That was only a glimpse of that which I presented to you. And the whole world was listening. And actually the whole world listens it through MTA. So the blessings of Allah Almighty are countless. When Allah Almighty gave the assurance that inni ma'aka, that I am with you, then Allah Almighty testified this company, the assistance of Allah Almighty, that now more than 200 countries, this water of the mercy of Allah Almighty is descending in more than 200 countries. Yeah. Huzur says that when Allah Almighty addressing him said, Anta mim ma'ina wa hum mim fashal, that you are from our water and these are fashal, they are absolutely useless and good for nothing. So the one who is from the water of Allah, he is going to irrigate the world, and the blessing of this water, and no effort of the opponents can stop that. Yes, the activities of the cowards people, and by abusing, by using profane language and foul language and put hurdles, they have been doing it. They are doing it, and they will continue to doing it, as I have mentioned. But the Ahmadiyyat, the progress of Ahmadiyyat cannot be stalled by these people, can never be stalled by these people. But these people should also look that has anybody not given them any intellect, any wisdom? The people, when they go to these mosques and listen to their sermons, nobody has given them this wisdom. That by opposing the Ahmadiyya Jamaat, have they done any reformation for the Muslim Ummah? Where is this reformation? Is it in the field of tabligh? By doing the tabligh of Islam? By establishing live relationship with Allah Almighty, have they created such people? Have for the publication of the Holy Quran in the world, by translating it in the world languages, have they tried to reach the take this message to the people of all the world? Have they created the desire of this in the hearts of the people? If with the petrodollars and with the wealth of oil, if they have created some schools, are in the name of peace, they have opened certain schools in the, and if you have in, have they, if they have trained some people for the opposition of Ahmadiyyat, so this is not the teaching of Islam, nor it was the purpose of the one who came in the name of the mercy of for the whole of mankind, rahmatul lil alamin. So all these efforts which these so-called leaders of Islam is doing, has they removed the restlessness of the Muslim Ummah? As a matter of fact, that is aggravating and increasing. The description of the situation of Islam, which was mentioned by 100 or 150 years or 50 years ago, that is exactly the same today. Yes, if in the world, if the true picture of Islam, if it is to be seen in the world, by looking at that which people are appreciating the beauties of Islam, that is that Islam which has been mentioned by the Mahdi of the sage. And by looking at that, by listening to that, thousands upon thousands of Christians, they are accepting Islam, the true Islam, Ahmadiyyat. The same description which has been presented of the Muslim Ummah, these people, they are mentioning about that themselves. These are not our sayings, but on and off, these things are being mentioned. I would like to mention some examples of that. The very famous Alim of Sindh, Maulana Qasim Rashdi Sahib, he says that in olden centuries, despite that, nobody was cut off from the Muslim Ummah, and different schools of thought, Hanfi, Shafi, Maliki, and Hanbali, they were part of this Ummah. And terrorists, the people who love terrorists, and Hanafi, and not only, the Ahle Hadith is not ready to offer the prayer behind Ahle Hadith. Why they say Bismillah in silently, why they do not pronounce it loudly, whether they open up the hands after ruku. He says that my father once, he mentioned very sorry about this, that son, we used to say other people that they are kafir, their prayer is not a right prayer, but Allah has created so many people from among us. And they said that you are not Muslims and your prayer is not the true prayer. Now we have to open up our eyes. This reference is from Zarbe Haq in 1904, and there is another magazine in April. It is written that the question is asked that the Muslims, despite being Muslim, why they are beating up, why they are being defeated. We have got so much resources, why we are being defeated. So we are attached to religion of Islam, but why we are being disgraced so much? And he raised the question, and then he gives the answer himself. And he says that we have recited Kalima, and we consider ourselves as the servant of Allah Almighty. And in the Holy Quran, and the Holy Quran completely denies what we are doing. But we do these things, but the Holy Quran rejects that. There is a contradiction in our behavior. And when, if we don't make our selfish egos according to the Holy Quran, and we will not create the Islamic society, and our way of life will not be transformed in accordance with the Holy Quran, and our being a Muslim in name will not benefit us at all, but because of the blessing of the Islam, rather we will continue to become the target of the mighty powers. And if we have to be saved from defeat and disgrace, and if we have to save ourselves from the revenge of these powerful mighty powers, then either we should leave the name of Islam, either we should leave the name of Islam, only then we can be saved. Or we should simply, by naming it as Islam, we should practically do something according to that one. And without the establishment of Islamic system of Khilafat, without that, actually Islam is a means of disgrace. And there are organizations, there are groups, and all of them, they are safeguarding their own rights. This is Islam, and this is the definition of a Muslim they are giving. And this is also completely disaster and a matter of loss. And the Islam is that Islam which actually changes the people, which makes the people godly people and people of God. The true Islam makes it like that. And he says that the moral, the social values, they are changed, and the condition of the heart is changed, and international relationship is also changed. This is the Islam which the one who came from Allah Almighty has already printed. But if you have rejected this divine water, then the same thing will happen to you, what you are facing at this time. And Nawaiwakt writes in one of his edition that we are not getting those blessings from Islam which the people at the time of the Khilafat-e-Rashida used to have. At that time we used to find justice and love, mutual love, unity, and the dominance and victory of Islam. Instead of justice, we are cheating and injustice. And because instead of love, we have got the enmity. And instead of affluence, we are suffering. And instead of dominance, we are being subjugated. So what a great loss is there. What a bad condition is there. And what a great tragic incident is that. And when these people are completely deprived from the help of Allah Almighty, then this condition happens there. Then Nawaiwakt has written that he says that why we are so much disgraced today. And then he says that in Surah Baqarah verse 61, it is mentioned that the disgrace was imposed upon them, and they were overpowered by the disgrace by Allah Almighty. Because these are the words have been mentioned about the Jews. But if the current situation is analyzed, then we are the people upon whom the situation applies, the Muslims, and not the Jews. And he says that it should be clear that this in the verse 112 in Surah Al Imran, more or less the same subject is mentioned there. And mostly the commentators agree on this point, that the Maghzoobe Alayhim is the Jews, and the Zalin are the Nasara. But the fact of this is that the misguidance of the Christian is very clear. But the Maghzoobe Alayhim, who became the victim of the wrath, they are not the Jews, they are Muslims. And he says that our condition is the same. the description of which has the depicted by the Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in one of his hadith, that a time is going to come that despite the huge number, your condition would be just like the will be totally insignificant. And and the Muslims in the world today, they are facing great crisis in the world. So along with the grace and the honor and the morals, they have run into the moral corruption at that time. And this the regard of the religion and the sanctity, that is completely gone out of their heart and mind. So now you think over it, that this wording of the Holy Quran, that the disgrace was imposed upon them. So this actually applies to us. Is it, this is what they say, that this is not the Jews, this is the Muslims upon whom this disgrace. In the 16th April in Nawai Waqt, this was mentioned there. And these are the things which are mentioning themselves. Does all these things should not compel them that there is something? And at this time, there is someone who is calling Allah Almighty to his witness, and he is attributing all these things to Allah Almighty. And calling Allah Almighty for his witness, he says that I am from God Almighty. You can compete with me if you are in doubt. And he declares that Allah Almighty speaks to me. What I am saying, that I am not saying it myself. This I am saying because of Allah Almighty has told me. Allah Almighty has made me the Khatmul Khulafa of the Summat, because I am the follower of my leader and my guide, the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, and I am his greatest lover. And according to his prophecy, I have come. And I am the embodiment of the promises given to the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. My denial will bring the results that you are facing at this time. Remember that the revival of Islam, Allah Almighty has destined that it is going to take place at my hand. Still you have not learnt a lesson, despite all your efforts and the help of all the governments. And because of your wealth, despite all your wealth, you cannot stop the progress of the Jama'at. The blessings of the Allah Almighty cannot stop. You think and ponder over it. If this thing had been done by some human being and not by Allah, it could have been finished long ago. Hazur says that be wise and benefit from this water which has come from heaven. Hazrat Masih Maud Salatu Islam has repeatedly mentioned the need of the divine water. He has actually described the objective of his coming. In one place he says, in the heaven and the earth, there are links between them, just like the male and female. There are found wells in the earth, but they are depending on the water from heaven. And unless the rain comes, the earth is considered to be as a dead, and the life depends on the water which comes from heaven. That is why Allah Almighty say, "Elamu in Allah fahiya bil." And you think that when the rain stops, then the water in the well is finished, and the water goes at a lower level. But when there are rainy season comes, when the water level in the well rises, because there is an attraction between these two waters. And if the heavenly water stops, then all the wells would become dry. And that is, we feel that Allah Almighty descends a light on the hearts of the people, and there is an intellect, and as a result of this, human being is able to make a distinction between good and bad. But if the light does not come from heaven, and this system is upset, then all the human intellect will also become dark and they would not be able to function at all, because this system is benefits from the light of the prophethood, and just like the rain and all the, and similarly with the descent of the light of the prophethood, there is a clarity and a brilliance in the minds of the people created. And although it is according to person to person and according to their ability, people get the benefit from it whether they perceive it or not. But all these things, it all depends on the light benefit, light of the prophethood. And when the water does not come from heaven and the earth dies and the water in the well finishes, this is the law of nature. And Raja is the meaning of that is a water, but Zat Raja, the heaven, the sky has been mentioned like that. This rain is actually comes from the, and this is the expression which is used in Persian. This is also mentioned there, that when the rain is there, it is very refined, sort of blessing of Allah. And then there is a flower in the garden, and in barren land there are some growth there. And the same condition which comes at the time of rain, that is when the revelation comes, exactly the same situation. There are two types of people. One is very intelligent and one is a bit dull. And those people who are ready, they immediately recognize and they take side with that. But those people who are dull in nature, they don't understand, they rise in opposition. Look, when the revelation started in Makkah, Muazzama, and the revelation came to the Holy Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, then Abu Bakr and Abu Jahl, they were the people of the same land. Abu Bakr did not demand for any sign, and as soon as he heard the claim, he came along. And Abu Bakr saw signs after sign, but he refused, and then he died a disgraceful death. And he says that this revelation from Allah Almighty makes the people clearly, and the good and the bad, they are made clear. When there is a spring, at that time, it is not possible that any seed should not be growing there. But whatever is bad, then it will not come out. And the good seed gives the growth, and the bad does not give the growth. And this growth comes out of the land, then it is they are both distinct. So the farmer looks after the useful crop and throws away the harmful. And this has been described in this one. And the ignorant people, they do not understand this. As a matter of fact, there is a great deep philosophy in. That is why Allah Almighty says, وَسَّمَاءِ ذَاتِ الرَّجْعِ. Allah Almighty by saying, إِنَّهُ لَقَوْلٌ فَصْلٌ. Allah Almighty says that this revelation from Allah Almighty, it is regarding the wording of Allah Almighty by way of revelation which comes. This is a very clear, this was a matter of thought which has been mentioned in this physical way, that whenever there is a drought, there people are in need of the water. So this time is just like a dead land. This is at the time, the land and the sea, there is a corruption everywhere. Disorder is there. And Ahle Kitab by the earth, and the ignorant people that representing the water, the seas. So there is disorder and misguidance all over. And you see in any respect, the condition of the life of the world has been changed. And we do not see the signs of any reformation. And in moral corruptions and deviations, the young and old, they are involved in that. Everybody is involved. Therefore, there is a need at this time that the light of prophethood and the rain from heaven should come. And be grateful to Allah Almighty that Allah, by the grace of Allah Almighty, He has descended, caused this water to descend. But very few people benefit from that. Only those people benefit who have the yearning for that. They want to search this water. And I mentioned yesterday many examples I quoted. In the first day of the Jalsa, I also mentioned some examples during the time of the promised Messiah. And now as well, that how Allah Almighty guides those people who are pious in nature and good-natured. In the time of the promised Messiah, these people were guided and they satiated their thirst with this divine water. This is continuing. And the right-minded people, they are going to satisfy their desire and it will continue. And a spiritual revolution is being created among those people who do the bath. This rain water is coming in Africa, in Asia, in America, in Australia, and in also in islands, everywhere. And today in the international bath, and representative of all nations were there. They are the living proof of the fact that the blessing of Allah Almighty continues even today. I gave several examples who were guided by the dreams. There are certain dreams in which it was clearly told. I did not mention all the dreams because they were very long. And the water which is coming through the ulama, that has gone very deep, and irrigation cannot take place as a result. And the water which is going to irrigate the fields, that can be only achieved through the promised Messiah alayhi salatu wasalam. He says that the fact of the matter is that when the Imam of the age comes, then so many blessings of light they come with, and everywhere there is the life, and the light spreads everywhere, and the good faculties, they are brought to life, and they woke up. And we are seeing the examples of this. And after that, how can we say that the divine water has not come and we should be deceived by these people? How is it possible? So I say to all the people, to the generality of the Muslims, I say, many of them, they are always listening to what we say, that, oh, blind people. And I say to the ulama, the so-called ulama, that don't be deceived by your selfish egos, and those people who are called ulama by the people, do not use this Muslimaan, don't exploit these people. By inciting these people, you are the people responsible for shedding their blood. How long you are going to be calling for the need of the Imam of age and deviating the people from the right path? You will be rejecting the Imam of the age. You believe that the time is now actually demanding that the water from heaven should come. And when the water has come, you are not benefiting. What a strange thing is there. You confess and admit the punishment from Allah Almighty. And many people, they have admitted this point, that the punishment has come. So have fear of Allah Almighty. If you don't change your condition, then Allah Almighty might not give you some punishment sweeter than that one and stronger than that. And when the punishment from Allah Almighty comes, then they are completely annihilated. And the condition of the Muslim Ummah, the condition of their disorder and the injustice of the rulers, and the narrations of all these increasing injustices, and all these things which are trying to defame the beautiful face of Islam, and you are asking the non-Muslims to capture your wealth, all these things are there. Does it not create any fear in your hearts? Be wise, get up, wake up, and when the wrath of Allah Almighty comes, then it does not leave anything behind. Complete annihilation is there. Or, O ye followers of the Imam of the age, those who have benefited from this divine water, which has given you a new life, you also discharge your duties. Your relationship with Allah Almighty should become strong. Show the right path to the world, and deploy all your faculties and abilities. And your religious and spiritual and moral levels should be raised. Enhance that. because so that you can do full justice to the bath of the Imam of the age. And you should become such crops from these fields which are useful to other people. And you become those canals and rivers which benefit the mankind, and always fresh water is coming into that. And this spiritual provision has to be given to the people through the Imam of the age. And now this thirst is going to be quenched with the water which has to be provided by the followers of the Imam of the age. And there is no other group who can bring the people closer to Allah Almighty. If we did not discharge our responsibility, then we will be questioned. So we should also do everything subservient to the will pleasure of Allah Almighty. And we have to make a resolve today. And we should make this resolve and then get up from there, that we will always give preference to the religion over the world. And in order to discharge the right of our bath, we have to completely use all our capabilities and abilities and powers. So now Allah Almighty enable us to do so. So now we are going to pray, remember those captives, the prisoners in outside Pakistan and in Pakistan. Remember Ahmadis in Pakistan, particularly in Punjab. Injustice is at its highest point. In every respect, the oppression is being done. And those people who are suffering with certain diseases, Allah Almighty look after all of you, and you go back to your home safe and sound. Now please join in prayer.
Ameen.
No!